The Kitchen by Chef Omar Albert. Welcome back to the show.
Thanks for having me.
And what everybody's saying, Omar, just so you know, sort of down my ear and in general, is every time you come on, you get more and more handsome.
Goodness me.
It's true. I'm kind of feeling...
Come on.
Good-looking fella.
Don't embarrass me in front of the country, please.
Yeah.
Thank you.
TV hunk Omar Albert, but it should have said on my autocue. So, how are you? What's new in your world?
Very well, very well. I can't complain, actually.
Yeah.
All very happy, generally. So, working hard as usual, as you know.
Because I think last time I saw you, you were just about to open Newcastle.
Newcastle, which
and
is now open.
Gone?
Very well, actually, luckily. You know, Jordi's... I sort of feel they are kind of the most Spanish of... In here, very sociable. They go out a lot. They go out in groups, which is unusual to see. And I've opened Bath as well, which is completely different. Quite a lot more tourist and very local and so on. But, you know, very good. I'm very happy with
it. How many more are we going to do this year, then?
Hopefully another two this year. Yeah, maybe Oxford.
So that'll take you to eight?
Eight, yeah. So keep expanding Tapas Revolution. Slowly, you know, it's taking me time, but enjoying.
It's almost Tapas Evolution, not Revolution. Thanks very much. Right, what are we cooking today?
So I'm going to cook pescadito frito, fried fish, but it's quite different than British style. It's only coated with flour, so a lot lighter. So I have a mix of seafood and shellfish. So I have some red mullet, some squid, white bait and prawns, and I'm going to accompany it with alioli, which have a bit of a twist. Done differently with milk instead of egg, and as well garlic, vinegar, mustard, and olive oil.
No, because are we coming up to quite a big festival in Spain at the moment?
Well, Carnival. It's Carnival time this weekend, and it's kind of celebrated big time in two cities, really, in the country. One in Tenerife, in the Canary Islands, and the other in Cádiz, in the south of Spain, in Andalucía, which is and it's good fun, you know. Probably it's a bit different than the Rio or the Venice ones. It's not just all about the dressing up. In Cádiz particularly, they have what is called the chirigotas, which is, you know, they're groups of bands, groups of friends, really, that they get together and they make really funny songs about politics or trending topics, and it's really good fun, and they all dressed up as one.
So is it a religious festival, or is it just a celebratory festival?
It's a celebratory festival. Right. It's not religious at all, and that's why there is not that many traditional dishes in that comes with it. Generally, in Spain, all the traditional dishes have a religious connotation in terms of, in this case, there wasn't. But this is sort of a street food dish that you will get in very much every street, as it's a street festival.
Yeah.
There.
Now, this dish that you're doing, could it be fair to describe as a tapas dish?
It is very much, and actually, what I have in my hands, this squid, deep fried squid, is the most sold tapa in my restaurants. Full stop. I mean,
Tim
it's
has
number
an issue
one.
With tapas.
What is your issue?
I don't, he's making it up. I love tapas food, but why can't you bring it all out at the same time so I know what I can eat? Because the problem is, you bring the little dishes, and then I'd never know how much more I've got to come. And if there's three sausages and there's four of us, I don't know whether I can eat one or not. Why can't, if you bring it all at the same time, then I know what I'm doing.
So let me explain. The reason... it's pretty hard in a kitchen, a tapas kitchen, when the checks comes in. You don't have a starter and a mains for one person. You have four things. So if you see the check in a kitchen that the head chef needs to control, is huge, full of numbers, you know, plenty of things.
Yeah.
So it makes it very challenging. As well, because they are all the small things, we like to send it fresh, as it's ready. If I have five dishes waiting for the last one to arrive, you're going to have it stale. And I'd rather you have it as fresh as possible than...
It's a good explanation, but all the other kitchens in the world do it.
Because really, and it's all for sharing. Why put in, what's your issue, Tim?
Is there a mathematical equation we can apply? So we've got eight guests sitting around the table there.
Yes.
So if we're gonna, if Tim is going to order for everybody,
yes,
is there a general rule that we should be looking at?
Probably three, four tapas pair. Per person, but it all comes down to letting yourself be guided by the waiter, because the size of the tapas varies depending on which restaurant you go to, and you cannot predict that.
Yeah, and obviously the waiter will want to sell the most expensive ones to you, or the ones that they've got on special offer. No, of course they won't. No.
What are you saying? No, not really. And actually, that's a very good point. You know, I think one of the things, you know, it's not just to know how much amount you're ordering, but as well, let me wash my hands. But as well, in case you order too much fried food, for example, you had patatas bravas, squid, croquetas, maybe you need a salad or something that cuts through it. And that's why you should let yourself be recommended.
So there's a good bit of engineering to be done. So when Tim's taking everybody out, which he does every week, he takes all of the guests out for lunch.
After the show, they're all coming.
Yeah. and he never normally does tapas. So when he does tapas this weekend, so we're looking at what, 24?
Yeah, that'll be a feast. Really, that'll be a fit. Or maybe, but you'll order probably two of each of the tapas so that each is shared between four, generally. I think that'll be a better mix.
Does that help, Tim?
No.
No? Sorry, didn't I explain it correctly? No, so you'll order 12 tapas. You said 24, yeah. 12 tapas, but twice of each of them.
Okay.
So at least everybody has a number of bites.
Just to throw another kind of tricky one into the mix, Tim, maybe this is it, is the ration rather than the tapa.
Yes, that's maybe a bit more main course.
Okay.
But supposed to be in a main course normally is made up of a number of items, you know, whether it's a garnish, and so, you know, and this will be maybe a ration of meatballs will be just 12 meatballs instead of six. That's kind of a better way of explaining it, just a slightly larger.
There we go.
So what am I doing?
Back with the recipe. So we've fried off the mullet already.
The red mullet, very lightly. You know, I'm just tapping it with a bit of kitchen paper so that it's not oily. The trick is that it's, you know, the oil is clean and it's hot.
Yeah.
And that makes great fried food, generally. Yeah. And in this other side, I am doing mustard, chopped garlic, salt.
Yeah.
And now I have the two liquids. This is what it's a bit of an invention, a bit different, is that instead of doing it with egg, like you would do with mayonnaise, I'm doing it with milk.
Okay.
And I did this for the restaurant purpose again, because there is a lot of pregnant women or people which is
not wanting to use raw egg.
So I thought I'll do it with milk. Yeah. And you'll see that it sort of emulsifies the same as you would do with an egg.
I like that. That's a really nice idea.
Slowly, yeah. And this is olive oil.
Yeah.
Not extra virgin, so that it's a little bit milder.
I think sometimes using extra virgin olive oil in things like mayonnaise, it's too much.
Could be.
It's too overpowering.
Too astringent.
Yeah.
At times. And yeah, definitely a bit too strong.
Yeah.
The taster. So that's why either you do a mix of vegetable oils and extra virgin, or you just do a mild olive oil.
That's great. The texture's amazing.
Yeah, quite thick. And I'm just going to add a little bit of vinegar just for acidity, just a touch.
I wonder whether you could do that with some of the milk substitutes as well, whether almond milk
would work in that.
I wonder whether it would emulsify.
I have no idea.
No, I don't. I'm just thinking out loud. That would be. I'm intrigued.
I'll try it because I'm very into. I'm asthmatic. So I'm very into coconut milk at the minute.
Right, we're rapidly running out of time.
There you go.
Lovely guest, would you like to come over and share our tapas?
I'm not sure
if we've ordered enough.
Let me just season this lightly. Bring the mayonnaise for me, please.
Time to put that in you.
Yeah, please.
Wow.
Ready.
A little lemon.
That's got an amazing texture, Omar.
Thank you. There you go. Finish. Nice fried fish. Street food style. Pescadito frito.
Wow.
Nice. Wow. Share it, tuck in, and enjoy.
All right.
Go for it, ladies and gents.
Very simple today.
Go for it. I'm going to go for one of those.
But hopefully very good.
Going to be hot, guys. It's just from straight out the front.
Yeah, be very careful.
Good.
Yeah. Nice and crispy.
No strawberries.
That is delicious.
Good too.
That's cool.
Lovely to see you.
Always good to see you. For all of us in Refresh Beach, head to the website, telegram.com/